Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasagaran University, India. Today's topic is how to compare the signals. We call this correlation. For this, let me explain about autocorrelation, cross-correlation, and normalized correlation, and some applications will be introduced. And what is correlation? What is the correlation? Means now there are two signals, x of n and y of n here. Then how to calculate similarity? Similarity means correlation, same meaning of two signals. For this, similarity means how much amount of component of yn is contained in x of n like this. Also, this similarity can be expressed by this equation like this. Now you can see here, denominator y of square n, and the numerator is a summation of x of n and the y of m. Now in this case, denominator, this is one of the constant. That means it's not dependent on the x of n, and therefore, just this one, we call this similarity function for this. Like this, this equals zero means completely different. Means another word, you can say the two signals are orthogonal each other. By the way, let me think these two signals. X of n is here, the amplitude equal 1, 2, 3, and y of n is a shift of x of n to the right side by 3. We call this x, y of n. Now you can see here, this is also amplitude equal 1, 2, 3, same amplitude. Then now here, x of n and y of n is identical except delay by 3. Okay, in this case, let's calculate this one. Means now here, 1 into 0 equals 0. Also, 2 into 0 equals 0. 3 into 1 equals 0. 0 into 1, 4 into 2, 0. 0 into 2, 0 into 3 equal all 0. This is obviously wrong. Therefore, we need to modify these equations. This similarity equation, the formula, this one, should be modified like this. This similarity, in order for this similarity to have some amount of similarity between x of n, one more time. In order for this equation to have some similarity between y of n, for this we need to modify this term y of 10 with some the shift parameter like this. For example, in this case, we can say y of n to y n plus 3 like this. Then obviously it's correct. Therefore, generally, what we can say, this similarity function, we cannot use this one. Therefore, for this, we modify like this. That means now we have to add the shift parameter of this here. This is a shift parameter. Parameter, okay? Now, therefore, correlation, Rxy of m is dependent on the shift parameter like this. We call this cross-correlation. Okay, correlation, just before I said, cross-correlation is like this. Okay, now also this is a function of m is a shift parameter. In this case, y of n, x of n, y of n is equal, we call this autocorrelation. And this is different, we call this cross correlation, meaning we Rxx of m and Rxy of n. We can represent like this. And also, normalized cross correlation. Means this cross correlation divided by square root. This is the autocorrelation of x at m equals 0. Or this is the autocorrelation of y at m equals 0. We normalize, if we normalize this term, we can get normalized cross correlation. And also, normalized autocorrelation means this term. Now here, this is autocorrelation and all same denominators here. We can get here. We call this normalized autocorrelation sequence like this. And this is the normalized cross correlation sequence. The how to, let's have some of the practice how to calculate correlation between this. Now, as I mentioned before, cross correlation is like this. From this means, you can see here, multiplication x and y, and summation like this. Now, for example, x of n equal 0, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, this. And also, y of n equal 0, 0, 10, 20, 30, like this. Then from this, we need to calculate, in order to calculate this cross correlation, now here we need to shift. First, we shift y of n equal this. Now, 10 to this by 2, to the left by 2. Then this is y of n. That in this case, this is y n plus n plus 2. Therefore, in this case, this means m equal minus 2. Then let's calculate. 1 in now this here, 1 into 30. Therefore, okay, 1 into 30 plus 2 into 0 equals 0. Therefore, all equal, this equal 30. Okay, this is 30. 30. And we shift to like this. Then by 2, this is, you can see y n plus 1. This means m equal minus 1. Then now we can calculate 1 into 20. 1 into 20 plus 2 into 30. 2 into 30 equal 80. Okay. Next, we shift here. Then this is y of m. And this means m equal 0. Now here, 1 into 10. 1 into 10 plus 2 into 20. 2 into 20 equal 0 into 30 equals 0. Therefore, this is just 50. And this means y n minus 1. That means m equal 1. Then now, 1 into, that you remove this one, it can remove, no need this one. 1 into 0 equals 0. 2 into 10. 2 into 10. And the 0 into 20 is 0, therefore equal 20. Then finally, we can get here cross correlation of x, y, m. Okay, now let me change the color. R, x, y, m equal, now here 30, 80, 50, and 20. Another one is 0, 0, 0. And also this is 0, 0 comes like this. We call this, finally, we can get this cross correlation of x and y. This is one of the example how to calculate the correlation, how to calculate this equation like this. Okay, it's very easy to calculate. It's a little bit complicated, but it is easy. Okay. Then next, y of n equal this x of n y of n. From this, please solve this one and this one. Normalized, normalized cross correlation and the cross correlation. From this, we can do this. From this and this one. Normalized autocorrelation and the normalized cross correlation. This first of all, please solve this problem by your hands and then compare and check the result with this result. I attached this one, then you can try to code and make this one. Then you can get this one. Now, here x of n. And autocorrelation of over x, y of n, autocorrelation of y of n, and the cross correlation of rx, y, mn, and the normalized cross correlation below x, y, like this. The first, please calculate by your hand this one, this one, this one, and check your result with this MATLAB source code. Okay, from now, let me give you some application field. Okay, now, x of n is here, and y of n is here. The amplitude equal, of course, amplitude equal, this is 1, 2, 3, and the amplitude equal 1, 2, this is 4, and another y2 is 1, 2, 5. Then our purpose is how to x of n similar to y of n and y 2n, which how to know. You can see, you can expect this 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, this means maybe this one, this is more similar than this. Then how to calculate quantitatively, this is which of yn is more similar to yn, we call this similarity. Similarity means just I said normalized cross correlation. Okay, first we compare this one and this, then you can get a normalized cross correlation. This one, this value, this value, this this this. Okay, and you compare this one and this one, and you can get the normalized correlation of this one. Now you can see here, maximum normal critical coefficient is this one, and here this one. You can see this is greater than this. That means x of n similar y, more similar y of n than y to n, like this. X of n and y of n are more similar than y of 2. From this equation. Therefore, by using this, we can know the selecting the similar waveform, similar signals. Like this, normalized cross correlation is useful for selecting the signal which is similar to input one. Okay, this is one of the application field. Another application field is like this. One object is here, and some transmit signal is here, go to hand, and the reflected signal is XR, this X of T and RT. Then from this, we want to know the distance. You mean distance is velocity into time. Then here, velocity means this is air, sound, therefore we can say 340 meter per second. Then this one is problem. How to know this delta of t? For knowing this, we use normalized autocorrelation. Then you can see here, you can get this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. This means delayed by 2, we can get the same signals. You can see here, this is by 2, delayed by 2. Then, therefore, this distance equal velocity into time means velocity equals 3/4 t, and the time is this means 2, delay means the one, this is 1 millisecond, therefore round 2 millisecond, therefore one way is 2 by 2, one way is we divide by 2 this one, then we can get this one distance law. Like this we can know distance by using this normalized autocorrelation like this. Okay, this is the source code of MATLAB. Please, you have to be careful to this, how to input x of n here. For example, you will be asked input x and y, then you need to, this one, you have to use this bracket. Then, for example, 1 or 2. And also, y also, you need to bracket. Do not forget to use this bracket, okay? Do not bracket. And for the 3, 4, 5. Also in this case, y, length of y is greater than length of x. Now this is length of 2, this is length of 3. Or 4, 5, 6, you can do that. Then you can see the many kind of graphs. It's very easily to understand, the concept of correlations. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today, I explained correlation of two signals. First concept means similarity, and I explained cross and autocorrelation, and normalized auto and cross correlation, and two applications are introduced. Next topic is properties of correlations and the relationship of correlation and the convolutions. Very similar and different. And also different. Okay, please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.